Yo, hey everyone, Supremisis here, and in today's video, we are going to be looking at the Operation Outbreak operators that are actually coming with the new DLC for Operation Outbreak. Now, before the video does actually begin though, I would just like to say thank you guys so much. We just recently hit 500 subscribers, and I haven't been able to make a video pretty much all week because I've had school and stuff like that, but I would just like to say thank you guys so much for the amount of support that you guys give me, and for the amount of time that you guys give me out of your day to actually watch my videos. And I really hope that I bring some joy into your guys' life. I really hope that you guys are actually enjoying the content that I'm bringing out. I know recently it's more been about like content and the stuff that Ubisoft has been releasing, but I'd just like to say thank you guys so much. I really do appreciate every single one of you guys. And we are going to go ahead and not waste any more time and go ahead and jump in and have a look at these operators. So the first operator that we're actually going to be having a look at is Lion. Now, Lion by far has the best concept art in this game that Rainbow Six Siege or Ubisoft has actually ever made, in my opinion. Now, I'm not going to go ahead and get into the bio because I don't find that very important. I find his loadout more important than anything else and his gadget. So as you guys can see on screen, this is Lion. He looks really cool in his concept art. I really think like it's just amazing. So we're not going to waste any more time. I'm going to jump into his loadout. He is one of the two attacking operators. They're both attacking operators. Like, there isn't a defender. They're just both attackers. So quick disclaimer to get that out of the way really quickly. Now, Lion has a gadget where it says EE1D allows Lion to survey hot zones and maintain quarantine protocols on missions. He uses it to detect movement in an area in order to determine if someone is breaking quarantine, curfew, or a perimeter. Now, essentially what this means, in my opinion, that I think that there's going to be a bomb type game mode where you need to plant the bomb in a specific area. He will activate his ability, and then you will have like that 30 seconds of knowing exactly where the zombies are coming from, and you're able to counter that with his ability. I'm not exactly sure, but that is my opinion, and we're going to go ahead and actually jump into his gadgets and, his loadout. So, for his loadout, he has a vector with a drum magazine called the V308. Now, essentially, like I've already said, it is the vector with a drum magazine, as you guys can see. Now, the vector is one of the most high-powered guns in this game as of right now because of its fire rate and its damage. Now, the only thing that, in my opinion, is holding this gun back from being the best weapon pretty much in the game on a defensive operator is not having enough bullets in the actual magazine. Now, as you guys can see, it has a drum magazine on the attack. Now, this is going to be an absolute machine, especially to deal with hordes of zombies of like six of them coming at you at once. So it's going to be really easy to deal with these zombies. I think it'll be really easy to use. And as you guys can see in the loader as well by the screenshot up on screen right now, he also has Twitch's DMR, Twitch's shotgun, Twitch's pistols, and that's essentially about it. Now, this operator is a 2-speed and a 2-armor. He also carries a claymore and a stun grenade, which is really good, especially with his ability. Having that claymore, knowing where the zombies are coming from most, you can put that claymore down and hopefully get like a triple kill with a claymore or something like that. But we're going to actually go ahead and jump on to the other operator and have a look at what her gadgets are and what her abilities is too. Now, moving on to Finca. She is the female attacking operator for Operation Outbreak. Now, as you guys can see, her icon and stuff like that as Finca, I think she is by far the better attacker in my opinion. One, because of her ability, and two, because of her loadout. Now, if we actually go down and actually have a look at her ability and her gadget and stuff like that, I'm not actually going to read the entire thing because there's a couple words in there that I don't know really like how to pronounce properly, but I'll give it my best go. So it says, Finca delivers a nanobot shot to each operator before an operation. The nanites are made of zinc, with the, I don't know how to say that word, cocktail laced into the nanobot's construction. When she activates her signal, the nanobots disintegrate with the zinc treated as a nutrient by the body and facilitating the absorption of the drugs. The operator or operators receive a short boost of health and get them back on their feet to give them an extra push and steady their aim. Now, essentially what this means is that her gadget is like Doc's gadget. She will shoot all five of the attacking operators, including herself, I'm guessing, with these nanobots. And what the nanobots does is when she clicks RB, it'll give you a boost in, I'm guessing, speed, armor, and like recoil pattern of everyone's weapons. So I think that this is really good in my opinion, because if you run into like a horde of zombies, you activate this ability and like you're not even going to have to control the recoil or anything at all. You're going to have more health, more armor, more everything, and you're going to absolutely shred through all of these zombies. Now, going into her loadout, she has the spear .308. Now, she also carries around T'Chanka's shotgun, Fuse's LMG, and the pistols that they actually have on their loadouts as well. So we're not actually going to have a look at that. We're actually going to have a look at the gun that she's carrying around. Now, in my opinion, this does look like the AUG. Now, I know the AUG is already in the game. I know IQ already has the AUG and stuff like that. But if you guys have a look at like any other game, like Ghost Recon Wildlands and stuff like that, the AUG, I think, looks like this. Now, I don't know exactly what the gun is. I'm not exactly sure. I'm pretty sure that my like representation of that gun is wrong. But in my opinion, I think that this gun will be an absolute machine, and being able to run like a grip on it as well is going to be absolutely insane. The gun already looks good in my opinion for an attacking operator, especially with her gadget, so I'm actually really happy about this. Now, she is a 2-speed 2 armor. She carries a breaching charge and a stun grenade. Now, I mean, I'd say give her a grenade instead of a breaching charge. Like, I mean, I guess it is really good that she does have breaching charges though, because being in Operation Outbreak, I'm guessing you're going to want to need someone who can actually breach instead of like bringing a thermite and bringing someone like that. And I'm guessing zombies don't reinforce any of the walls. So, I mean, along the lines of that, I'm guessing it is like really good that she does have breaching charges though. So yeah, that is about it for the operators actually. I hope you guys did actually enjoy this video. If you guys did actually enjoy the video, then please let me know by liking the video. And if you guys do want to see some more Rainbow Six Siege content on this channel, then please hit that subscribe button. We just recently hit 500 subs, and it is absolutely insane. So thank you guys so much yet again. I really appreciate every single one of you guys so goddamn much. But thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you guys did enjoy, you guys know what to do. And with that being said, and with that out of the way, I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.